In this video, I'm gonna show you how to create a t-shirt design using the Canva app on the iPad. It's all gonna be on the iPad, and I'm gonna show you how to upload it to things like Merch by Amazon on Redbubble. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005. And in this video, I wanted to teach you how to do that on an iPad. So a lot of you are mobile friendly, don't have a desktop, maybe just have an iPad, and you can do all of this stuff on an iPad. So I'm gonna show you how to use the Canva app. I've been using that. If you saw this video right here, it's my 31 days of design. I've done a lot of those designs on the iPad in Canva. So real easy to do. I'll show you how to do it. I'm not gonna show you everything that the Canva app does. I'm just gonna show you how to do this design right here. If you want more Canva iPad tutorials, let me know that in the comments. I definitely can show you how to use the whole thing step by step. This one is just a quick overview of what kinds of things you can do on Canva. And then I'm gonna show you how to upload it to Merch by Amazon and Redbubble, and you can use the same techniques to upload it to any other pod site that you have, Etsy or whatever it is. So let's get into the Canva app on the iPad right now.
All right, so here we are on my iPad. I'm gonna show you where to get the Canva app first. So you go to your app store, click on there, and then you just type in Canva like that, and you'll pull it up. You're gonna see that I already have it installed, so it says open, but you'll be able to say it. It'll say get for yours if you don't have it, and it's absolutely free. It's gonna tie into your Canva account, so if you have the pro version or if you have the free version, it'll know. You can see here, this is the subscription trial for pro version if you don't have it already, but you can do it through the app as well. So I'm gonna cancel this and get out of here, and you can see I have it right there along with all some of the other ones. I gotta show you these in another video, but here's Canva. Just open it up like that, and it opens up quick, and you can see it remembers who I am, just like the desktop app. So now that we're here in Canva, let's start a new design. I'll show you how to do it. We'll just hit create design, and we can do custom, and we'll remember the things that we have on here. So I'm gonna do 4,500 by 5,400. Just click on there, or you can type in here, but I'm gonna do this. You can see it right away. It's gonna pull it up. Pretty easy, right? So fast. Next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna type on elements, and let's go look for like just a graphic. So I'm gonna do cat and coffee. Right? Whoops, I spelled that wrong. F-E-E, right? Cat, coffee. Let's see what we got. And then let's just go graphics. And you can see all the graphics are right here. Pretty cool, right? Really fast. So let's just pick one of these, just like we do on the desktop. I'm in the pro version, so I can use any of these. If you don't have the pro version, you can't. So let's just pick that. And then to size it, you just hit the corners, just like you would on here, but you can use your finger now. So just, you know, put it right there. And then see magic recommendations. You got a bunch of them here, so let's do some. Oh, these are the ones that I use for one of my designs. So I'm gonna do that. So let me get rid of that. You can see it's so easy. Got this guy here, and you can just size it, right? And let's do a bunch. I don't know which ones I used, but I'll just use ones here. Here, maybe pink on this side. And then let's see. Oh, that one's funny. Oh, this is a dog. Why not for the dog? Hey, let's do a dog version instead, since I already have a cat version. See how easy it is to come up and then... There's a dog here, dog here. Whoops, that's cropping it, whoops. So you don't wanna crop it. Let's see. Okay. And then I think I might have tapped it too fast. Can always get out of it. So click on here. On this one. And if you want to move the position, you can go position and forward, just like the desktop. We need one more here. Which one didn't we do yet? Dog, dog. This one's fun. All right. Okay. Now, one thing you can do is get a bunch of them together. So I believe you can do this and then select multiple here and then start doing that. Now, this whole thing is a group. So now I can hit group and then kind of scale it by themselves together, right? So now that they're in a nice group, I can move them around, make some room for some text. All right. And now I believe, yeah, so they're separate now still. So I didn't actually group them. So next thing I'm gonna do is add some text. So let's add some text. So to add text, I'm just gonna go here to the text. There, I can add text box. Since I don't have Command T on my here, I just add text box. And I can say easily distracted, maybe shift, whoops, that was a lowercase. Easily distracted by, oops. All right, that's good enough. And then I'll put dogs and coffee underneath. We can click on it and move it up here. And then we can still do the effects. See that? The curve. Just like you would expect it to do. And then you can pick a font too. Find one here. Boom. That's a cool one. Right? And then if you want a different font, of course, you can pick whatever font you want. Easy. Just touch it with your finger. All right. I'm just going to pick that one. We may want a thicker font there, but that's okay. And then let's scale these guys down again. So again, hit the dots, hit select multiple, boom, boom, boom. Scale it down. See how easy that is? Okay, and then dogs and coffee under here. So add another text box. We're gonna do dogs and coffee. Boom. Click on it, and you can easily make it bigger too. Just grabbing the corners, boom. Okay, so let's just say this is the design that we wanna save. Of course, I would change it up and make it thicker, and there's still a lot of work on it, but let's just say this is ready to go. So what I would do is click on this to share and then save with transparency. This button right there, save with transparency, click on that. And then I already did this already, so I'm gonna show you what I did. I'm gonna save it to my files here. So I'm gonna click save files and it's in my iCloud drive. I click the untitled folder here and I'm just gonna save it. So I already did this, but this is what I would do. Hit save and it's gonna save it to your iCloud drive and folder. When you save it to your photos on here, it doesn't actually recognize it. So you're gonna have to save it like as a file instead. So that's my workaround. You could probably save it in other places, but this is what works for me. So I have my iCloud drive here. I hit save. I'm gonna cancel on this one, but it's in there, trust me. And then go into Redbubble or Merch by Amazon. Either works, I'll show you both. First, let's log into Merch by Amazon. So here I am, Amazon Merch. You can see Redbubble's next here. All you wanna do is just click on here and look for your file. Now remember, I didn't put it in my photo library because it didn't work that way. But I can choose file here and then I had it in my iCloud drive. So I'm gonna go iCloud drive, right, and desktop, and remember it was in the untitled folder, and there it is. I'm gonna click on that, and it's gonna spin, and now this one has the transparent background, right? Remember we saved it for the transparent background, and it's thinking about it, and once it does, it's gonna load it onto these designs here, and you'll see it come up. There you go, and we'll do the same thing with the titles and description, but I just wanted to show you that it works, right? And then you hit save. So you can see transparent background and everything. So if you've done this on the desktop, same thing, just go in and type in your titles and keywords. We're not gonna do that today, but I'll just show you that it does work, right? And then Redbubble, you're gonna have to sign in. So here, if you haven't signed in, you'll see here an option to sign in, but I've already signed in. So here's Detour Shirts, add new work, right? Upload new work, And then again, choose file, same one, and it should do the same thing here, right? So remember, this is the workaround, is to make sure that you save it to a file, not to your photos. And you can do all of this on your iPad. If you're on vacation or have a good connection, you can see same thing. It's all on there, and you can just do the same thing like you did on the desktop, stickers and whatever it is on Redbubble. And you can probably do it for the other print-on-demand shops as well, but I wanted to show you that it does work, at least for these two. I'm sure it works for TeePublic and all the other ones. Just make sure you use the right file.
So that is it for this video. Hopefully this video was super helpful for you. If it was, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, hit that subscribe button right there. It really helps in the algorithm. The question of the day for this video is, what other iPad apps do you want a tutorial for? Do you want more Canva tutorials? Do you want me to show Affinity Designer or some other iPad apps? There's so many things that you can do on the iPad, Procreate and so on. The list goes on. Let me know that in the comments. Thanks again for watching. And if you want to see more videos like these, click on these right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.